Hi, my name's Lucy and today I'm going to talk to you about data transformation. So why do we sometimes need to transform our data? Well, primarily data transformation is done to help correct non-normal data. And if you're wondering what non-normal means, I'll explain in the next slide. It also allows your data to meet the assumptions of a number of parametric tests like linear regression. And lastly, data transformation can make patterns in your data more interpretable. And for this reason, it is often done even when your data does largely have a normal distribution. So this is what we mean when we say your data has a normal distribution. The mean, mode, and median of the data is centered, and the distribution of your data is uniform, so it is nicely balanced either side of the center. The fastest way to know whether your data is normally distributed is to visualize your data first using a histogram. As you can see from the top picture, this data follows a normal distribution with uniform variance and a centered mean, median, and mode. However, the bottom two examples do not have normally distributed data, and this is what we called skewed data. In the bottom two examples where we have left-hand and right-hand skewedness, you could not use a parametric test like linear regression without transformation, as the data does not meet the assumptions of being normally distributed with uniform variance. There are three main types of transformations that are used to normalize data: the logarithm, the square root, and the reciprocal. We call these transformations variance stabilizing, as their main purpose is to make the variances either side of the center the same, helping our data to meet the assumptions of parametric tests. I'm not going to go into the mathematics of each type of transformation, but let's look at the advantages of each method and what data type is most suitable for each one. The logarithmic transformation is the most commonly used type of data transformation. It usually works best for highly right-skewed data, but can be used for both left and right-hand skewedness. It cannot be applied to zero or negative values, and it is most appropriate for continuous variables, such as height or distance. So here is the distribution of a data set before and after performing the logarithmic transformation. As you can see on the left, this data is very highly skewed. However, following transformation, its mean, median, and mode are centered, and its variance is uniformly distributed. The square root is a transformation method with a moderate effect on distribution shape, so it is weaker than the other methods. It is also typically used for reducing right-hand skewedness and has the advantage that it can be applied to zero values. It is most commonly applied to count data, especially if the values are mostly small. The reciprocal is a very strong transformation method which can have a dramatic effect on distribution shape. It shouldn't be used on zero values, and whilst it can be applied to negative values, it is generally the most useful when all the values are positive. The advantage of using the reciprocal is that it can often be easily interpreted in terms of your original data. So exactly how do you transform your data? So data transformation can very easily be done in softwares like R and SPSS. You can also do it in Excel, and if you wanted to, you can even do it by hand using a calculator. However, I wouldn't recommend this as it is very time consuming, and you can very easily do it in a software that has a built-in function, especially for data transformation. So I hope you found this helpful, and good luck.